the internet. Me. Orang cakap besok cuti tetapi dia bohong sebab besok kan satu tempat saja cuti ya. Entah nak?
Thank you.
untuk Isnin cuti bohong tu lah. Tak ada itu tu kak selongor saja.
Banyak covid ya.
Tapi bukan lah. Itu bukan selongor, kita mana cuti ya. Itu dekat teren kami ya cuti ya. Teren kami.
Suspecting that everything would soon change. It all started when I got sick. It was winter, and I, being the fate's favorite, was one of the first to catch some kind of flu. I went about a week in bed with chills, coughs, fever, and headaches. You have no idea how glad I was when all of this nightmare had ended and I finally got better. In addition, Christmas was approaching, which meant that there was going to be a holiday party in our school soon. And this, by the way, is one of the best parties that our school organizes. No, really, you just can't imagine how amazing it is. There were going to be chocolate fountains, gifts, fireworks, delicious food. Of course, I really wanted to go. But my mom didn't care. She wanted me to stay at home, and as she said, recover completely. Well, of course, am I going to miss the party of the year because of some cold? That's nonsense. As a result, I had a huge fight with my parents. They even put me under house arrest, and I had a fever again because of the stress. If you think that after that I humbly stayed home, then you are very much mistaken. On the day of the party, I locked myself in my room and boycotted my parents, which made them really mad. And while they were thinking about what to do with me, I was sitting calmly in front of the mirror, doing my hair, choosing a dress, and wrapping the gifts for my friends. I've made friendship bracelets for them and couldn't wait to present them. The only problem was my parents, who refused to let me out of the house. Fortunately, my room was on the first floor, and it was not difficult for me to open the window and get outside through it. This was how I went to the Christmas party in a beautiful dress, as well as shoes, and without a coat or a hat. My school was located not far away, only 15 minutes walk from my house. But even in that time, it was enough for me to freeze to the bone. Passersby were looking at me as if I was crazy, and at that moment, I really regretted that I had not thought of taking at least a cardigan with me. When I got to the school, I was shivering, my forehead was on fire, and my ears were plugged. Despite this, I was happy for about 5 minutes. Before I even had a chance to hug my friends, I felt dizzy and dark spots appeared before my eyes. I could not stand on my feet and I fell to my knees right in the middle of the hallway.
Then I fainted.
I came to my senses at the hospital, having terrible hallucinations. I did not understand what was going on. Stars were sparkling and horses were galloping before my eyes. I felt like I had gone crazy. I almost don't remember what happened next. I just know that I soon fell asleep, and when I woke up, I realized that my new life began. First of all, I could not open my eyes for a very long time. Rather, I did open them, but for some reason I could not see anything. It seemed to me that I was still asleep and just wasn't able to wake up. I even gave myself a slap in the face to come to my senses. Then I heard my mother's worried voice. She asked, "Natalie, what are you doing?" And then I understood everything. I realized that I was blind. I got really hysterical. I was crying very loudly for a very long time. I didn't want to be blind. The doctors even had to give me sedatives because crying made me feel short of breath. And I have no idea how happy I was when I regained my eyesight the very next day. And 2 days later, I was already discharged from the hospital, but on the condition that I would spend the whole holiday at home under a warm blanket with medicine on the bedside table. To celebrate my recovery, albeit incomplete, I decided to arrange a small party since I actually did miss the Christmas party. I also didn't manage to present my friendship bracelets, so there were plenty of reasons to organize a private party. I called my friends, invited them to my place, and spent the whole evening in the kitchen baking Christmas cookies for the upcoming holiday. I finished everything at around midnight, and I was so tired that I fell asleep as soon as I touched the bed. I woke up after hearing a loud doorbell and the cheerful screams of my friends outside the window. I immediately realized